2.0, and we're really excited, of course, to include this gentleman behind me in this program. Thank you. It's refreshing. Just when we told Jack that he was going to be included in this year's class, he was so gracious, and it was really neat to hear him talk about how when he was a kid, which is, you know, that he had always dreamed of being included on a wall banner with Mr. Muhammad Ali and, of course, you know, Griff, Denny Crum, Jennifer Lawrence. So we're happy to make your dream come true today, Jack. Okay, let's move on so I can get all the important people up here. Here we go. First, I want to introduce to come up to the podium Congressman Morgan McGarvey, make a few comments.
They moved around seats, so I got to be the not cool adopted Harlow son today over by Maggie and Brian. Welcome, guys. Welcome. This is awesome. Bear with me a second. There's a quote from a famous judge who said, he said, I don't know how to say it, but I know it when I see it. I think that about cool. What is cool? Can't tell you what it is, but I know it when I see it. Jack Harlow is cool. His style is cool. His beats are cool. His lyrics are cool. His heart is warm, and that makes him cool. And more importantly than that, he makes sure that people know Louisville is cool. Whether it's JCPS, Atherton High School, whether it's our hometown, my hood of the Harlands, Jack Harlow, he made Mid-City Mall look cool. And we are so lucky to have him as an ambassador, as a representative to the world of what Louisville, Kentucky is, the 502. And I can't think of anybody more deserving to have their face all over our hometown in our week of Derby than Jack T. Harlow. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Congressman. Next, I want to introduce Mayor Craig Greenberg for some remarks.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's wonderful to be with you all here on this beautiful day and our Derby, Kentucky Derby week. You know, speaking of the Kentucky Derby, this is really, Jack, for you, this is quite the trifecta, maybe actually even the superfecta of weeks for you here. You started off your week at the Met Gala. Then we've got the amazing banner today. You announced your fantastic foundation earlier today. And then the Kentucky Derby, which I know from our conversations is one of your favorite days. And so it is so extra special to be doing this here during Kentucky Derby week to honor one of Louisville's favorite and best sons that we have, not just because of his music, but really because of what you're doing for our community, Jack. In your videos, obviously, with your recent video showing off our city, in your lyrics, but really it's your giving back that to me is the most impressive thing that you do, because you want to give back to Louisville. You want to make Louisville an even more special place than it already is. You had a great time growing up, you've shared with me, and you want every child in Louisville to have those same opportunities, to have the same opportunities that you had because of your great parents, Brian and Maggie, who are amazing people, and you want to just continue giving back. So it is my honor and my thrill to be here to help honor you, to help say thank you on behalf of the entire city of Louisville, because you've done so much for our community, and I know you're just getting started. This is just the beginning of Jack's contribution to the entertainment industry and to our city. And so it's not quite as big as a banner, but I'm gonna call up my wife, Rachel, and my son, Daniel, who's got a little proclamation here. Come up too, Rach. Again, it's obviously this looks teeny in comparison, but today, on behalf of the entire city of Louisville, we are making today, May 3rd, 2023, Jackman Day. Congratulations, Jack.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor. Next, I want to introduce Governor Andy Beshear to make a few remarks.
All right. Thank you all. I don't know what you took away from that last speech, but I think the mayor has banner envy. And frankly, so do I. Listen, Jack Harlow is a sensation that I know we are all proud of. Just think about what he has accomplished. He is a Grammy-nominated and multi-award-winning artist. He's the only person that I've ever met that's hosted Saturday Night Live. He's reached number one in the Billboard's Top 100. This year, we're going to see his acting debut in the movie White Men Can't Jump. But what's so special to me about Jack Harlow is I cannot remember a time when someone at least at this time, the height of their career, said they were going to move back to their home state. They were going to move back to their hometown. At a time when Jack could have chosen to be anywhere, literally anywhere, he wanted to be right here with us. How special is that? When we think about how people are introduced to Kentucky and introduced to Louisville, when we go back in time, another person who has one of these banners, Muhammad Ali. You think about other brands that are out there where people first hear of Kentucky. You have Kentucky Fried Chicken. You have bourbon. And now we have Jack Harlow. Just think about the number of people that have never heard about Kentucky, that have never heard about Louisville, but through his music are introduced to us. I don't know about you, but I am so proud, not only of his success, but I'm proud of how he cares about this community, and frankly, from getting to know him, how much he cares about everybody. Yeah. I'll let you in on something that earlier this week was a secret. I'm proud to call Jack a friend of mine. We've developed a friendship over the months that I get to see this man for who he is. He is kind. He is talented. He is smart. He is giving. He is honest. He is looking for ways to make a difference through his music and in his community. And when you hear this new album, if you know him, you truly hear his authentic, raw voice in it. And you hear so many messages that can be so important to this community with what we're going through right now, but with all of Kentucky. At a time when Kentucky is winning more than ever before, at a time when we're bringing in more jobs and more opportunities, sorry, I have to do a little bit of the governor thing, than ever before. I mean, this just adds to our momentum. At a time when we're building the biggest battery plant on planet Earth, when people are picking us, Jack Harlow decides to move back home to, yeah. And it's pretty special that not only has he moved back home, but his home was ready for him, embracing him, giving him both the love and at any time he needs it, the space to create the art that he creates, and recognizing him with what is a pretty incredible and a pretty amazing honor. So it is true, today I do have banner envy, but I could not be more proud of this guy, of what he represents, of how he represents us. So you didn't come here to hear me. Let me introduce you to Brittany and my friend, and an incredible Kentuckian and Louisvillian, Jack Harlow. I want them to put mine right over here, and we're going to stare at each other.
I would love that. Wow. I feel pretty emotional right now. You know, I just want to say thank you to the Greater Louisville Pride Foundation for organizing this whole thing, everyone that organized this event, everyone that took time out of their day just to come up here for this. It really means a lot. Thank you. Thank you, Mayor Greenberg. Thank you. You know, Governor Beshear. Thank you, Andy. Appreciate that. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you, everyone. I mean, this really means the world to me. You know, it's like I grew up, you know, driving around and you would see these banners and take them in, and they were a point of inspiration for me. And sorry, I'm a little lost for words. I made a point not to write anything down because I wanted to see if I could speak from the heart today. But if someone could ask me if I would rather have a Grammy or this, I would choose this a million times. And my home just means so much to me because, you know, as I've slowly traveled the world and toured and met people in all these major markets and been in dimly lit restaurants and, you know, ran into people I idolize, it's all very exciting. But I think I've had this epiphany over the last year or so that, you know, if I don't nurture what was here for me from the beginning, you know, there's a chance you can end up with nothing if you don't take care of what was already there. And, you know, I just feel such a foundation with this city. And I feel so indebted to this city. You know, it's not strategic that I shout this place out so much. It's just part of my identity. And I grew up watching rappers like Outkast, and, you know, they would tell the story of Atlanta, or Kendrick Lamar talking about Los Angeles. And so it almost became second nature to me by the time I was a preteen that's what you do when you're an MC. You know, you get on the mic and you tell the story of where you're from. And I tried to be authentic the whole time. You know, that's been my main goal. And, you know, I'm still growing up. I'm figuring out who I am. And but my goal this whole time is to be authentic, and I continue to strive to be as authentic as I can be. So all I can do is tell my story. So, you know, this is just exciting. Thank you. Thank you so much. Seriously. I really appreciate it. And thank you to all the officers that are here today that are, you know, taking time away from focusing on everything else just to give me this half an hour. It really means a lot.